In this video, we're continuing on with the Visualizing Data Worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off with numbers 5 and 6, we're going to be drawing a box and whisker plot for each data set. Now, an important aspect of box and whisker plots is that we're going to be splitting the data up into quarters. So we're going to be working with medians of the data. And because we're working with medians, it's important to order our data. However, in number 5, it's already ordered from least to greatest for us, going left to right. So finding our first median, we'll cross out the lower number, cross out the highest number, cross out the next lowest, cross out the next highest, and so on, until we reach that middle point. Now, we're left with two numbers because there's an even amount of numbers in this data set. That means we need to find the number between 31.1 and 31.5. And in order to do that, we're going to add 31.1 and 31.5 together. And then once we add them together, we'll divide by 2. So 31.1 plus 31.5, adding those together or summing them, and then dividing that by 2 will give us the number in between. So 31.1 plus 31.5 is 62.6, and when we divide that by 2, we'll get 31.3. Now, because this is the median of our entire data set, that's going to represent quartile 2. So Q2 is equal to the median of the entire data set, which is 31.3. Now, for a box and whisker plot, we also have to find quartile 1, and we have to find quartile 3. Now, quartile 1 is the median of the lower half of that data. So the median of our entire data splits it in half. So now we're going to look for the median of our lower half, which are the circled numbers. And then we're also going to look for a median of our upper half. So let's start by looking for the median of our lower half. Again, in the same fashion, crossing out the lowest and then the highest points, our quartile 1 falls in the middle of 27.6 and 28.9. So we're going to add 27.6 to 28.9 and then divide that by 2. That will give us the median of the lower half of our data. So 27.6 plus 28.9 divided by 2 will give us 28.25. Next, we'll find the median of the upper half of our data. So crossing out the lowest point of that upper half, and then the highest, and then so on, we will get 34 and 34 is where our median falls in between. However, 34 is the same number, so quartile 3 is 34. So now let's start drawing our box and whisker plot. We'll start with a line, just as we did a dot plot. And it's essentially going to be a number line. Making sure I take into account our lowest data point of 26, all the way up to our highest data point of 45, which I'll count by twos, so I'll have 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44, and then 45 will be approximately here. So now let's mark our quartiles. And when we mark the quartiles, they're going to be straight lines because they're going to help form the box of the box and whisker plot. So 28.25 occurs approximately here. Then we have 31.3, which is approximately here. And then finally 34. So there is my box, where this is Q1, Q2, and Q3. Now we're going to graph the rest of our data. However, we need to take into account outliers. Now, an outlier is a point that's extremely far away from the main data. And the way you calculate an outlier for a box and whisker plot is that you have to take into account the interquartile range. The IQR is Q3 minus Q1. That's the interquartile range. Q3 minus Q1 is going to be 34 minus 28.25, which 34 minus 28.25 is equivalent to 5.75. So if our IQR is 5.75, now we can calculate if we have any outliers. And we have to check on both sides. We have to check to the left of our data and to the right of our data. We're going to be able to use that number to find our outliers, but we're going to need to multiply the IQR by 1.5. If we have a data point that's 1.5 times the IQR lower than the Q1, which is our quartile 1, then it's an outlier. And if we have a data point that's 1.5 times the IQR greater than quartile 3, then it's an outlier. So first let's calculate 1.5 times the IQR. And that's going to be 1.5 times 5.75, which is 8.625. So we're going to take 8.625 and subtract it from quartile 1. So 28.25 minus 8.625 is equivalent to 19.25. And 19.625 is lower than our lowest data point. So 26 is not an outlier, therefore it will be the end of our box and whiskers plot on the left. Now let's check for data points on the right. So looking at our quartile 3, 34, we're going to take 34 and add that to 8.625. 34 plus 8.625 equals 42.625, which falls between 36.7 and 45. Here we would have 42.625. And because it falls in between, that means that 45 is indeed greater than 1.5 times the IQR plus quartile 3. So because 45 is greater than that number, 45 is our outlier, so we'll mark 45 on our box and whisker plot, and then 36.7 will become the end of our box and whiskers plot, where 45 is that outlier. And that's how you draw a box and whisker plot for a data set. So quickly again, you find the median, which is quartile 2, then you find the median of the lower half of the data, which is quartile 1, the median of the upper half, which is quartile 3, and that will form your box. Then you have to check for outliers, and once you find those outliers, mark them and mark the ends of your data point, taking into account any outliers are not included in that box and whisker section of your plot. And another thing to note about a box and whisker plot is that it splits the data in half. So our data is represented graphically. Here's a quarter of the data. Here's a quarter of the data. There's another 25% of the data. And finally, this is the last 25% of the data. So it splits the data up into quarters, taking into account those outliers. And that's because it's based on the medians of the data. Let's continue on to number 6. In number 6, we're looking at the age at inauguration. And our data is not ordered, so we're going to need to order it. So the youngest is Theodore Roosevelt at 42. So we'll have 42. And then the next youngest, if there's any 40s, we have 47, Barack Obama. After 47, we have two 49s. So writing 49 and then 49. Next, we'll move on to our 50s, which we have 150. And then next, we have three 51s, Calvin Coolidge, Arthur, and Taft. So writing all three of those in. And then next, Abe Lincoln at 52. Then Buren and McKinley at 54. So two 54s. Then Lyndon B. Johnson at 55. Grover Cleveland at 55, so two 55s. Then we have James Madison at 57. Now we're moving on to our 60s. where we have Truman at 60, Ford at 61, and then Taylor at 64. So there is our data ordered. And what I like to do is I like to double check to make sure I didn't miss any by counting. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 data points that I've ordered. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, indeed 17. So now we're going to find quartile 2, quartile 1, and quartile 3. So Q1, Q2, and Q3. So we're going to be finding that middle number. So cross out 42, cross out 64, cross out 47, cross out 61. And do this back and forth until we reach that middle number, which we will have a middle number since it's an odd number of data points. And that's going to be 52. So our quartile 2, the middle of our entire data, is 52. So quartile 2 is 52. Now, I'm going to look at the lower half of our data, which will not include 52 since it's directly in the middle. So crossing out 42, crossing out 51, going lowest to highest, crossing out, we'll have a number between 49 and 50, which directly between 49 and 50 is 49.5. And that's because I know that 49 plus 50 divided by 2 is 49.5. Or you can think that 49 is 1 away from 50, so halfway in between would be 0.5 away from 50 or 0.5 away from 49. Next, for quartile 3, looking at this upper half where 52 is not included since it's directly in the middle, we'll cross out 54, then 64, 54, then 61, and so on until we get 55 and 57 as our middle numbers, and halfway in between 55 and 57 is 56. So quartile 3 is 56. Now I'll draw my box and whiskers number line, taking into account that 42 will be my lowest tick mark and 64 will be my highest tick mark. So after 42, we'll have 44, 46, 48, 50, 52, 54, 56, 58, 60, 62, 64. So labeling those, marking every other. Now I'll graph my quartile 1, quartile 2, and quartile 3 marks. So quartile 1 is at 49.5, which occurs between 49 and 50, which is approximately here on our graph. And then 52 falls here. And then finally 56 is quartile 3. And then I'll connect those, forming our box of our box and whiskers. And now we need to check for outliers. So remember, in order to check for outliers, we have to look at our IQR, which is Q3, quartile 3, minus quartile 1. That's 56 minus 49.5. 56 minus 49.5 is equal to 6.5. So if our IQR is 6.5, we're going to take 1.5 times our IQR, and then subtract that number from quartile 1 or add it to quartile 3 and see if any numbers are less than or greater than respectively. So 1.5 times 6.5 equals 9.75. So I'll take my quartile 1, which is 49.5, and subtract 9.75. And that gives me 39.75, which 39.75 is less than our lowest value. Therefore, 42 is not an outlier and is the end on the left-hand side of our box and whisker plot. Now let's check for an outlier towards our upper half. We're going to take 9.75 and add it to 56, quartile 3. So 9.75 plus 56 equals 65.75, which 65.75 is greater than 64. Therefore, there is no outlier towards our right either. So there's no outlier on our data set. So 64 will be the other end of our box and whisker plot. So with there being no outliers, 42 was our lowest point on our box and whisker plot. and 64 was our highest point, which creates the whiskers of our box and whisker plot. So the upper 25% and the lower 25% of our data. And then our box is that middle 50% of our data, split in half by that median. And that wraps up these examples of box and whisker plots. Join me in the next video where I'll complete this worksheet drawing a histogram for numbers 7 and 8. However, before you continue on, remember to click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your peers.